is set up for you to fail. So shut up if you detail a plan where equality could develop. We have a voice, they tell us, as if the chief would hail us and care for us, completely selfless and not selfish. However, it's the wealthiest that control the laws of the land and upheld justice, yet they're all felons. How could a congressman understand city dwellers who deal with death and theft when his childhood was sheltered? The people who tell us what to do can't even connect with us. The first presidents thought they were helping us, but only messed with us and effed us up. They thought they were intelligent, but created a system that's actually an enemy to us. That's why there's no election trust. We can go and rock the vote and die, whatever. The Electoral College outmeasures us. So really, the man put in office is chosen by senators and governors, and not the people who live in America. Of course, if you're moving up in the government, you only do things to satisfy your peers to further your career. And certainly not in the public's interest and benefit. It's private interest, legitimate, and put business over resident. In cities, half is the richest and half is the detriment. They purposely split it so only one side is pretty. The grass and the hedges get massive attention, while the other half is neglected and they laugh at citizens. Who wants some of that money so family-owned stores could have more business with an impact that's significant? The government claims that they would fix it, but they don't have enough for one city to evenly divvy it. Well, then they must be idiots. You don't have to keep the city split. What's wrong with taking the land and splitting it so the two would equally enjoy the tax money they're giving it? They know what to do and do it. They're not quite that stupid, but they're only out to ruin their lives and secure their own future. The founding fathers thought we'd have no sense proven to choose our leaders, but we are all only human. So the system under which you live makes your voice useless. The voting booth is your own crucifix. Those in power choose who's next.